Hey there, my name's Derek, and I'm a master's student researching curling stones at the University of Edinburgh.
This project is supervised by Drs. Florian Fusace and Ian Butler here at the School of Geosciences, and is financially supported by the Scotland Saltire Scholarship, the Mineralogical Association of Canada Foundation Scholarship, and the Young Mining Professionals, the Yamana Student and Mining Scholarship, with research funding from the Moree Endowment Fund and the Edinburgh Geological Society.
Curling is an Olympic winter sport where athletes slide stones across a sheet of ice. By the way, did you know that curling stones, which are used in international competition, only come from two places in the world? That's Ailsa Craig in the Firth of Clyde of Scotland, and Trefor on the Llyn Peninsula of North Wales. But what makes these rocks so special, and why can't we use any other granite? Well, during a game, curling stones collide into and displace each other, and over time these collisions result in the buildup of damage in the striking bands of curling stones. Some curling stone types seem to chip more than others, so if we can understand how the internal grain structure of rocks influences the development of fractures, we can determine what properties make these rocks suitable for curling stones. We first have to look at curling stones themselves and compare between fresh and damaged samples. We photographed and 3D scanned striking bands to analyze the shape, size, and distribution of these curved fractures. We can also image thin slices of rock or thin sections using optical microscopes and scanning electron microscopes, and this will allow us to determine where fractures form in terms of grains and pores. Next, we need to quantify the forces and stresses of curling stone impacts, since they are ultimately the cause of damage in curling stones. We've conducted a series of on-ice experiments using pressure-sensitive films and high-speed cameras, and as far as I am aware, what I'm about to show you is the first ever high-speed camera footage taken of a curling stone impact. All right, don't blink. Okay, that was pretty cool, so I think we should watch it again. Now, you can see that the collision takes a very short amount of time. In fact, it's only about 10 frames or a quarter of a millisecond. You can also see some magnificent rock dust come off the stones, and this is another important aspect of damage, since we know that the profile of striking bands tends to flatten and become concave over time. Finally, we can try to simulate curling stone impacts experimentally by breaking rocks under controlled conditions. We've used X-rays at a research facility called a synchrotron to image rocks in 3D and in real time as they are deformed in a rock press. This method of imaging is similar to a CT scan that you might get at a hospital, but we use much brighter X-rays so that we can image rocks in real time. The results of my master's research will help us to take better care of curling stones, but they also provide a unique window into the accumulation of damage in granite-like rocks, and this is important in construction, mining, and also nuclear waste storage.
Thanks for watching, and if you'd like to support my research, you can do so by sharing my story and donating to my project. If you like this video, make sure to hit the like button, and if you want to see more videos on curling stones research, make sure to hit the subscribe button and then click on the bell icon so that you get notified when my videos come out. And until then, remember that minerals rock.